So we've heard this is the season of art.
This is all about art. There's no Tatiana Maslany this season.
No.
Yeah. It's just me in a squad car.
And clones
of me.
And
all
art loves art.
Art loves art.
Some people may remember that art actually loves art.
He says, I love art. So we get to explore all of that this season.
Awesome.
I mean, it's a great opportunity for me this season to jump sort of back into the story, you know, on a bigger level. And begin to answer some of those questions, you know, not me specifically, but I mean overall, that some of those questions start to get answered for the fans of the show.
Mm-hmm.
So for me to be a part of it was really exciting, and I think the stories that we're telling are going to be extremely exciting. And I'm looking forward to people getting a chance to see it.
Did you realize that you were going to be a bigger part of this coming season, like last season even? Did you know going in?
Well, I mean, these guys are doing their thing. And,
right.
I mean,
they give you
Graeme
any hints?
Graeme and I had a talk last summer, and we talked about, you know, what they were planning and what they were thinking and whatnot. So I think I had a general idea, but I think when the scripts actually finally hit your hands and you start to read it, you know, it's even more exciting. And I'm just really excited about people getting a chance to see it because the story just goes to a whole different level this year. And I'm just glad. Grateful to be a part of it.
Glad.
Plus,
I think art had a lighter season in season three. And mm-hmm. I think we knew that we needed you heavier for season four. I think that I think we kind of knew that.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So we heard that this coming season is actually, well, we were told it's as good as season one and better than anything that came in between one and now. Do you see that? I mean, do you see that the other seasons, like, building up to this one have kind of led to this huge, gigantic, great season that's coming up? I did not ask that question at all well.
Are you ranking our
season?
No, I'm not ranking your season. No, but I
said we're just not going to tell you.
But, yeah. Do you feel that the season has really hit, like, a new stride, maybe?
We're super excited about this one. Yeah. It's really cool once you've gone three seasons that you have worked up your own mythology and that you can dig into that mythology. And so we're excited that season four is really looping back to the beginning where it all started. It goes back to that moment on the train tracks and re-examines a bunch of things that we found really interesting. But charged past, and you have to sort of ask in this season, like, what did Sarah miss? You know, mm-hmm. what went past that she missed, or what mistaken assumptions did she have?
Plus, I think that we really wanted season four, after leaving season, after two seasons of leaving finales in, like, really dangerous, cliffhangers, we left three with a kind of feeling of security and, like, oh, everything's happy and we're all safe and now it's great to kind of sort of reset a little bit, and what we wanted was a real feel of returning, that feeling of season one, that feeling of, like, not knowing who the bad guys were and not knowing who we were supposed to trust, or who, in this instance, who am I? Am I supposed to be playing myself, or am I supposed to be playing one of my sisters? There's a little bit of that kind of thing for Sarah playing off her back foot and not knowing who the real bad guy is. So that's part of, I think, the season one excitement that we've tried to feed into season four.
So would you say the next season is going to be a little more lighter compared to the previous season?
Oh, I wouldn't say lighter. Lighter is not the right word to describe this season at all. Okay. This, if anything, I would say this season is much more fraught, is darker, probably a lot more emotionally complex, and certainly has a number of reveals that will, I think,
break the internet.
Especially for you.
Yeah, there are a lot of jaw-dropping moments, which are exciting. Yeah.
Speaking of moments that kind of broke the internet, that worm out of Neelan's mouth at the end, what was that, and how soon are we going to find out more about?
Well, that's kind of, you're going to have to, I guess, watch the show.
But that thing that with the big question mark worm thing, we will find out what that is.
Those are things that, like, you know, those are the things that we like to do as showrunners, to, like, you know, like, drop right at the end of the season to make everyone crazy, you know? And make sure that, like, you know, yeah, the network will renew us.
And smart move.
But no, we like to have each chapter kind of a new feel and a new vibe, and it's fun to tee them up right at the end of the previous season. So,
is there anything you can tease about New Clones?
Talk about MK.
Well, MK is we've sort of revealed her to some degree, and she's a sort of a mysterious character who has come from Beth's past, and she you know, has information about she's a kind of an information source for us, but because she is so elusive and cagey, she's difficult to pin down, and so she's someone that we like a lot.
Ooh.
Yeah.
I like the smile when you said that.
I never know what to say. I mean, I know that there's been some images and some talk about her, and I don't want to say a ton because I always like to leave it for people to see. But at the same time, you know, we have to promote our show, and it's a clone show, and we're always excited to talk about the new Tatianas. Mm-hmm. All our new Tatianas.
And Ari's.
Mm-hmm. Oh. And Ari's, yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Will we get to see, it was Tony, right, the trans clone?
Tony, yeah.
Yes.
Will we get to see him again?
I'd love to see him again, but we'll have to leave that mystery.
You've ended the last two seasons with, you know, first an adult clone dance party and then the family dinner.
Yeah.
Do you feel challenged now to one-up yourself with something like that? Something really technically challenging where you get everybody together?
Always.
we wind up getting ourselves into this spot where everyone expects us to kind of now be better, do more. So hopefully we've succeeded this year.
But technically, though, it's not necessarily more technically challenging to just put more and more clones in a scene.
Mm-hmm.
It's just more and more time-consuming.
No, but I think what's important is trying to do something that we haven't done
before.
Something we really
fresh,
haven't done, and something that's fresh. I think that's the more important thing. Not just how many Tatianas can you put in one scene, although that's pretty cool. this year, I think I think Graeme and I kind of like went, okay, what are we going to do for the finale, and how are we going to blow people's minds this year, and really sort of tried to kind of think a little bit out of the box, and so hopefully we've kind of succeeded.
Can't
I mean, we
wait.
Just finished shooting it like 3 weeks ago. So.